This is the Fujitsu Siemens Lifebook P1610, a small tablet PC from 2006. It has an 8.9-inch touchscreen display that is powered by an Intel Core Solo CPU clocked at 1.2 GHz. It comes with 512 MB of RAM and a 1.8-inch spinning hard drive. It runs Windows XP Tablet PC Edition 2005. Today I'm going to upgrade this to a solid-state-based storage. But first, let's turn it on and watch the little 1.8-inch slow hard drive boot. And as you can see, this thing takes upwards of 2 minutes to boot from that slow hard drive. So I'm going to replace that with this, a little mSATA SSD. This is a cheap 64GB mSATA SSD I purchased from AliExpress. And I'm going to insert this into the laptop and replace the original hard drive. Let's now shut down this and take out the original hard drive. Getting to the hard drive is quite easy. We just open the larger cover on the bottom, which should be held on by 3 screws, but on mine it's only held by 1 screw. And here we have the little hard drive. We unlock the ZIF connector and remove it carefully. And this is a Toshiba 1.8-inch 4200 RPM 60GB hard drive. This is the same hard drive you find in all the iPods, the third gen I think, because the newer gen use a different connector. And to adapt our new SSD to this, we need some conversion technology. Here I have an mSATA to IDE ZIF adapter. This is not the same connector as this. This is what you'd find on newer iPods. So we need another adapter. This is a 1.8-inch ZIF to the 1.8-inch hard drive connector we find on here. Connecting these together is not that easy, since you need to make sure that the pinouts are correct, because the pins go straight from one side to the other, so if you're not careful you could actually connect them in reverse if you use a different cable, and that might short something out. Now, I connect the little mSATA SSD, the label is backwards on this, and screw it in. To hold this together, I will use a little plastic piece to make sure that the pins on this do not touch anything here and short out, and also a little rubber band. And now we can just connect the hard drive connector here, and you cannot connect it the other way. With the connector sitting like this, it will not fit. I will also use another piece of this transparent plastic I took from an anti-static bag to isolate the board from the metal in here. I put this here and lock the ZIF connector. And the pressure of the back cover will be enough to hold this tight in place. Screw it all back together. And now we are ready to install the operating system. And now with it all put back together, I need to install Windows XP Tablet PC Edition, because it is the only version of Windows XP that supports the touchscreen on this device. And because with the low capacity RAM, only 512 MB, we cannot really run anything newer than Windows XP well on this machine. And to do that, I will use the network boot to load the image from my server. I have prepared a sysprepped image with all the drivers and everything required. And because this computer has a gigabit Ethernet interface, the install should not take that long. We can use F12 to enter the boot menu. You know, I will select the Windows 7 setup. We are not installing Windows 7, but we are using Windows 7's tools to deploy a Windows XP image on this computer. And here we are. We can select the language, click on Next. And now we need to log in on the server. This is a Windows Deployment Services server. So it will be and here we are. I will select the Windows XP WPC Edition 2005 for Lifebook P1610 image I have prepared earlier. Click on Next. We will delete any partitions on the drive currently and select the unallocated space and click on Next. Now the image will start deploying on the SSD. And now that we are booted into the out-of-box experience and the old drivers are installed, we can use the touch screen to start installing the computer. The on-screen keyboard blocks some of the options. Nice design, Microsoft. No, I do not want to protect my PC. I will skip the internet connection. Don't register with Microsoft. No, thank you. My name. And we are done. Let's move the keyboard back. And I think we can all appreciate how much faster that booted, considering it was the first boot, so I needed to create the user profile. So we said goodbye to this hard drive, to this marvel of engineering and miniaturization, because unfortunately these are obsolete. Modern SSDs are just better, even for these old computers. And since these are prone to failure, we should replace them with modern solid state storage to keep these computers going for longer. Thank you for watching and hope to see you soon for a RAM upgrade on this tablet.